Dear members of the EU STEM community, on behalf of the ZDU project that means shaping future through innovation, I would like to welcome you to the EU STEM Coalition's General Assembly. It's a pleasure to have you joining us online. Let me give you an overview of what we do at ZDE and outline how we see and address the issues of participation, empowering girls' interests in STEM, contextualizing, and out-of-school learning. The views and ideas of children and young people are at the focus of the ZDE community's activities. That is why we are keen to work with them to develop training courses and projects. Look, for example, at the Youth Science Camp program rolled out across the state. These bar camps for school students facilitate direct exchange between ZDE networks and the young participants. The youngsters talk about their concerns and interests and voice their desires and aspirations. This is met with approval from all sides and has lasting positive effects. After all, we communicate as equals in both the analog and the digital world. Our newly established Youth Advisory Board is another element. Young people from all over North Rhine-Westphalia have a say in every important decision made by the ZDE's central office. Participation of young people and others relies on yet another instrument, our unique e-community platform, STEM Community. The first community platform to cater to young STEM enthusiasts. That is where you find an overview of all the ZDE services. If you're interested in STEM, you can use it to link up with others and work on your projects. This digital network capability has helped to take the community to the next level, with more to come. Right from the beginning, the ZDE community has been aiming to reach out to and engage with girls and young women. On average, 45% of the participants in our STEM courses are female. Our out-of-school learning venues are a good place for girls and young women to explore what works for them. There's no pressure, and they are free to build things, tinker around, and try out new experiments. It's always okay to make mistakes. It's an approach Commissioner Gabriel is known to support. Hopefully, ZDE can inspire the EU STEM community with its activities. At ZDE, we are keen to make this visible and increase awareness for the issue. With that in mind, we decided 3 years ago to make October the month of ZDE Heroines, dedicated to girls and women who are active in the STEM subjects. The campaign is designed to promote the social media presence of girls and young women and provide them with space to tell others about their STEM experiences. There is also the opportunity for interested parties to get to know more about STEM courses and meet potential role models as an incentive to stay with STEM. Global warming, coronavirus, or digital transformation. STEM is everywhere. That is something we want to make young people aware of. This is less about swatting mathematics and more about teaching people when and how the context to use the acquired STEM skills. At ZDE, we are putting such contextualization, the application of STEM knowledge to specific situations, on a systematic footing. We live in a knowledge society, and it's becoming more and more important that knowledge transcends disciplinary lines. A solid foundation in engineering and the sciences helps a lot in other disciplines. Here I can see critical intersections between ZTE and the efforts at the European level, where, after all, issues like digitalization, the Green Deal, health, and new forms of transport are discussed. On that note, it's fair to say that ZTE is first and foremost a science transformation program. With their work, the boys and girls are doing their bit to resolve the challenges. For example, by soldering and programming CO2 sensors in classrooms during the coronavirus pandemic. Whilst we are, of course, working closely with schools, we are very specific about creating spaces in an out-of-school environment. To that end, North Rhine-Westphalia has a closely set network of student laboratories. Today, more than 70 out-of-school learning centers belong to the ZTE community. There's a variety of things on offer. Given that the labs are attached to businesses or universities with focal areas of their own, schools are included too, so that the equipment can also be used for classroom tuition. When it comes to promoting STEM subjects, touching, experiencing, and trying out things are important elements. At the end of the day, it's great fun for everybody. Thanks also to STEM. Whilst the labs focus on application, they also help the people understand the benefits brought by STEM knowledge. Thousands of people working full-time or voluntarily are showing plenty of dedication, ready to serve as role models for young people. At the same time, the laboratories provide a platform for youngsters to get involved with research. Young people interconnect between national boundaries. The Fab Lab seen here in Kamp-Lintfort is a case in point. My dear participants, take your inspiration from the ZTE community and please have a wonderful, productive, and creative exchange.